For some reason, there seems to be an abundance of content, especially in short-form videos, of people engaging, interacting, and interfering with nature. They usually personify wild animals and apply human morality to things that aren't human. Today, we're gonna look at some of these and break down why they suck for both animals and people.
The life of this turtle was about to end as it was being hunted by a huge shark. It desperately tried to rescue itself on a boat, but the shark managed to pull the turtle back into the ocean. The men on the boat noticed what was happening and had no other choice than to pull the turtle out of the water. You could see that it was already in a lot of pain, but relieved to be rescued. When they dropped the turtle back into the water a couple of miles away, the turtle suddenly acted very weird, so the men got into the water too. Then something unbelievable happened. The turtle came back to the men with a jellyfish to say thank you for rescuing him. So the men shared the meal with it. And if you think turtles are super intelligent, subscribe.
As you could see by this video made by Carl V, these people quote unquote rescued a sea turtle from being eaten by what is likely a tiger shark. Then after that, it shows a completely separate and unrelated video of a sea turtle eating jellyfish with divers around it. Now I know this content is auto-generated, but my god, do I despise the people behind it. If you're wondering why it's bad, well, let's do the math. Tiger shark plus sea turtle equals fully fed shark in balanced ecosystem. Tiger shark minus sea turtle equals hungry tiger shark in unbalanced ecosystem. A bunch of seemingly sweet old people in the comments are convinced that the people saving the sea turtle are saints. But what about the shark? Is it evil for eating meat? What else would it eat? Apples? It's really sad that people still think of predators as villains in the wild when they're just trying to survive the same as prey animals do. On to our next video by Carl V.
This mother kangaroo lost its baby while running away from a predator. As the baby was laying there, the predator thought its dinner was already served. However, the newly born kangaroo followed its instincts and ran off with all its strength. It got really close, with the predator almost biting its tail, but the baby managed to outrun him, who got exhausted and gave up. Finally, the baby found back to its mother and gave her a big hug. And if you think he truly deserved to live, subscribe.
There's not a lot to say besides that the mother didn't lose her joey. She dropped it out of her pouch to make it more likely for her to escape. It's actually a pretty common thing in some marsupials. And also, again, the ending of the video was obviously a completely separate clip. And now, on to our final video by Carl.
When this lion dangerously approached their car, it turned out it was just looking for hugs. He cuddled each one of them with a lot of love, and the people seemed to love the affection. And if you think lions are just big cats, subscribe.
That lion did not want hugs. Lions do not hug things unless they're actively clawing into it and trying to kill it or playing with another lion. What was most likely happening was the lion curiously approached the vehicle and became super confused when a bunch of weird limbs started to touch it. I hope you stub your toe tonight, Carl.
This deer was with its mother, but when called over, it rushed to get its head scratched, kneeling down while its mother waited far away.
Hello, guy.
In this video by Mark Bechet, you see a fawn approach a cameraman. Or woman, I don't know. But then it kneels down for quote-unquote head scratches. This is very abnormal behavior, and in the wild, the mother doe may have charged them for touching her fawn. The fawn kneeling down was a defense response because it was horrified. They become still because juvenile deer have a very faint scent that most predators find hard to sense. Leave nature alone, people. This next video is one of the most famous on this listing.
83 days ago now, I rescued lots of buckets of frog spawn and put them into my pond. And I estimated 2.8 million frog eggs. And a couple days ago, they left the water. And now there is thousands of little frogs hopping around the yard and all of the neighborhood. So follow along to see what happens. And there is still about half of the tadpoles left.
Rescued. 1 in 50 frog eggs live, and that's for good reason. They go toward the food chain where they're eaten by other organisms like snakes and insects. People are not taking this seriously enough. This is literal terrorism against the environment. The majority, if not all of those frogs, will die because of competition for food, and this will probably completely destroy the ecosystem around the area it happened in. This channel also inspired another person to release a bunch of ladybugs in a New York Central Park. Luckily, this person was charged with an environmental terrorism lawsuit, but they still haven't learned their lesson and have since moved out of the US and into Colombia to avoid it. Thanks for watching. I humbly ask for a subscription as it helps my very large and swagaliciously popular channel grow and become a slave to the algorithm. Bye-bye.